This is an introduction to taxicab geometry. In regular geometry, a circle is a set of all points equidistant from a center point. In taxicab geometry, you take the same idea, a center point, and it's all the sets of all points that are equidistant, but this time you can only travel left, right, up, down. So what I've got here is a geometry window. The geometry window is set up a special way. It's got grid paper with the grid turned on, and it's currently being snapped on. And I also turned off my labels because there's so many points that we're going to be plotting that we'll be able to, we don't want to get cluttered with all the labels. Next thing I want to do, I want to select a point, and the properties, I want to turn it red so that I can see where it's going. So if I start at the center, and I can only move left, right, up or down, so east, west, north, and south. That's why it's taxicab geometry. It's supposed to be based on an old question about taxicabs in New York City. So if you go over one, I'm trying to go over to four units. So I could go straight over, one, two, three, four. Or I could go three over and one up. Or one over, one up. That's two, three, four, gets me to that same point. If I go over two and then up two, I get to that point. Over one, up three. Over one, up one, two, three, gets me to this point. Or I could end up at the very top. Far left, bottom, and there's my point for my regular circle. Let's see what other points are available. Well, I could go over one, up three, or I could go up three and left one. So if you continue, you'll notice that you end up with the set of all of these points along this main diagonal. And what you end up with is something that looks very much like a circle, or a square, I should say, inside. So let's take, for example, let's create a path here. And this path, we will mark it with some purple lines. So I want to end up somewhere on the circle, four units. I can only travel four. So here's one. And I could go down. There's two. I could go over three. And then finally, four. So that path has the same distance as this path, which is four, which has the same distance as going over one, two, and up to, or going down three and over one. All of these are exactly the same distance from this center point. Again, you can only move right or left. And if you move left, you have to continue going left. You can't go left and then come back right, because that would be going double backtracking on itself. And in a taxi cab, you don't want to see that happen. In taxi cab geometry, we don't want to see that happen either. So taxi cab geometry is an interesting way of looking at distances traveled under very specific conditions. So give it a try. See what other figures you can define using definitions from taxi cab geometry. There's some really interesting applications. If you want to see an activity on it with a real map, check out the website with some free papers, some public papers. There is one on there called Uber/taxicab geometry, which explores the same idea.